Are you looking to buy that perfect piece of land for your next manufactured home, or mobile home, or modular home, or hang on, what's the difference? My name is Felicia. I'm a land investor and a partner at Compass Land USA. We have bought and sold hundreds of properties across the US, and I'm gonna go over the differences and disadvantages of a modular, mobile, and manufactured home, so you understand each one and you know which one you want on your next piece of land. Not knowing the difference between these can cost you thousands of dollars and totally derail your land investment. So you want to make sure you understand that to avoid lots of disappointment down the road. So let's start with a mobile home. These became popular as an affordable housing option in the post-World War II era. You can get kind of a sense of that from this image here from Curbed. A mobile home is actually a manufactured home built before 1976. In 1976, the government came up with the Mobile Home Construction and Safety Act. After this act was passed, all mobile homes had to pass the Housing and Urban Development, or the HUD, code. HUD is a national standard and requires manufactured homes to have things like a permanent steel frame. They dictate the minimum size required for the manufactured home, ceiling heights, how many doors and windows, stuff like that. So before 1976, it's a mobile home and it is not subject to the HUD code. After 1976, it's a manufactured home and it had to pass the HUD code. And it has a little HUD insignia on it for passing. So that's what a mobile home is. It's kind of like a predecessor to, or an ancestor to the manufactured home. It's really easy to confuse these two, and unfortunately, not everyone follows the same definitions. So when you're buying land for a mobile or a manufactured home, you want to give the county building department a call and really make sure that you guys are on the same page. An important note here is that a lot of counties just will not allow mobile homes, which is a huge disadvantage, obviously, if you already own one. So you want to make sure you clarify with them what their definition of a mobile and a manufactured home is. Okay, so you're good with mobile homes. Now let's focus a bit more on manufactured homes. Manufactured homes are built in a factory and are really a fraction of the cost of a traditional stick-built home. You can customize these with all kinds of stuff like hardwood floors, granite countertops. You can get pretty fancy with them. I've heard of people getting two-story homes, high-pitched roofs, big porches. So for example, this page shows a couple of Florida manufactured home listings, and you can see that they get pretty glamorous. If you've ever built a manufactured home, please leave a comment below. Let me know how that went. I've never done it myself, so I'd be really curious to know what your experience was like. Remember, they are subject to the HUD codes and will have the HUD insignia sticker on them when they've been certified. Now, the problem with the HUD or the HUD is it changes every couple of years. It's not set in stone. So that's something to be aware of when you're thinking long-term for resale value, if that's something that's important to you. So if the HUD changes and your manufactured home is out of spec, it could really decrease the value of it. When you go to purchase your manufactured home, it will come in just a few very large sections, and the number of sections will depend on whether you want a single wide or a double wide. So it'll get delivered to you on a couple of trucks and they'll finish assembling it, just kind of stick the single and double together on your property. Whether or not the manufactured home is adhered to a permanent foundation depends on the county requirements. Sometimes these homes are just put on a concrete or a limestone pad, and depending on the area, they might add hurricane straps to help keep it in place. If you're purchasing a manufactured home to bring onto your land, I think it's actually eligible for a loan. I'm pretty sure manufactured homes and modular homes are eligible for loans through traditional financings like a bank or credit union, that kind of stuff. But you definitely want to double check with your financial advisor, the company that you're getting the manufactured home from, and see what your options are. So a modular home is also built in a factory and has lots of options for upgrades and customizations. The main difference between a manufactured and a modular home is that modular homes get built in a bunch of much smaller pieces. It's much more similar to a stick-built house. So all the pieces show up, like frames, walls, windows, doors, and then they assemble it all together on the property for you. This is different from manufactured homes, which are delivered in just one or two big sections, pretty much already built and completed, and then simply just placed on your property. So modular homes are governed by local state building codes, unlike manufactured homes, which are governed by HUD at the national level. And state and HUD requirements are not always the same. So again, if you need financing for a modular home, I'm pretty sure it falls under a new construction loan, but check with your bank and the modular home company you're purchasing from and see what they advise. So both of those options are less expensive than a site-built home. If you're buying land for the purpose of getting a manufactured or a mobile home on it, there are a few things you need to be aware of. Obviously, delivery costs, installation costs, platform or pad construction if that's required, septic system permit and install, building permits, which you still need to get even though you're not doing a custom or a site-built home. Bringing electricity to the property is a big one, or connecting to an existing power line, or going solar if that's allowed. The permit and install for drilling a well, and I'm sure I'm probably missing a few, but this is a starting list anyway. Okay, so there you have it. You know the difference between mobile, manufactured, and modular homes, and have kind of a rough idea of what it means to bring one of these options onto your land. I hope you found this video helpful. If you made it this far, thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to leave a comment. Let me know if this was useful for you. Make sure you subscribe to our channel. We do lots of informative land buying related videos like this, as well as some pretty cool custom property tour videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.